Today I've been asked to share with you a message entitled The Godly Leader.
那今天呢，我就是牧师邀请我呢来分享这个主题呢，就是这个虔诚的神的神虔诚的领导。
And before we go on into our message, let's bow our heads for a word of prayer.
好，在正道之前，我们一起来低头祷告。
Father in heaven, we pray that whatever we are going to hear today,
我们天上的父，我们祷告今天我们所要听到的一切。
We ask that you open our hearts and our minds.
主啊，打开我们的心思，打开我们的心意念。
And under the inspiration of your Holy Spirit,
并且在你圣灵的启示的当中。
May your words be sown deep into our hearts.
愿主你的话语深深的在我们的心中扎根。
And may we respond to your word.
愿我们也能够回应你的话语。
And heed your call upon our lives.
并且能够遵行主你的呼召。
We commit ourselves to you in Jesus' name.
奉耶稣基督的名，我们把一切都交托给你。
Amen. Recently, some senior doctors left my hospital.
那最近呢，一些很资深的医生离开了我的这个医院。
These are very senior colleagues.
那是很资深的同事。
Of course, I will not tell you which department they come from.
当然，我不会跟你讲他们是来自哪一个部门的医生。
But after they left,
但是他们离开了之后
，as I looked around,
那我周围看了一下
，and I realized that nobody really felt sad for them to go.
那我感觉好像没有人觉得他们离开有什么伤感的。
These were senior colleagues who people looked up to as leaders.
那这些资深的同事呢，他们都因为资深的话，是年轻的一代都是很尊敬他们的。
Some had looked upon them as their mentors even.
那甚至有些把他们当成导师一般的。
Yet when they left,Nobody missed them.
但是离开却没有人去想念他们。
Even some were relieved that they had gone.
其实有些人还说，哇，松了一口气，他们已经走了。
Why this unusual reaction to somebody departing?
为什么有这样的有人离开？为什么有这样的不寻常的反应呢
？It might have to do with their leadership style, perhaps.
啊，有可能是因着他们的领导的方式吧。
It could have to do with their way of interacting with other people.
或者是呢，他们跟别人交往的时候的方式。
Or even perhaps the way they carried themselves, the way they conducted themselves.
或者是他们是怎样处事待人。
That may have left a lasting impression on others.
这些事情可能就影响了一些人对他们的印象。
So we ask ourselves.
所以我们就问了自己。
What is a leader?
到底领导是什么？
A leader is somebody who sees further down the road.
一个领导人呢是。是懂得就是长远的看到这条路的这个尽头。
Somebody has said that a leader is one who knows the road.
那有人说一个领袖呢，他懂得这条路。
Who can keep ahead,
而且呢能够继续的往前走。
And who can pull others along with him,
而且还能够呢带领别人跟随着他。
In other words, leadership is the ability to attract followers.
那意思就是呢，领导就是能够吸引人跟随的。
Somebody has said,
有人这么说
，He who thinks he is leading,
他若想到这个人若想到他是在领导的话
，and nobody is following,
但是却没有人跟随
，is only taking a walk,
那他只是在散步而已。
So how about Christian leaders?
那基督教的领袖又怎么样
？The world is looking for good leaders.
那这世界呢，在寻找着好的领袖。
The church is also looking for good leaders.
教会也一样在寻找好的领袖。
In fact, there are many Christian leaders who are outstanding in the world.
那其实全世界当中也很多很杰出的美好的基督教的领袖。
Let's look at some slides and see whether you can recognize some of them.
那我们要看看这个荧幕上看有没有认识这些人吧。
PowerPoint.
The pictures.
Pictures. 照片。有没有照片？你认识他们吗
？No, these are the only two leaders.
Okay, okay, good, good. Never mind, because I think that will take up more time, and I think we are short of time today. All right, let's quote down some names.
好，我们就提一些名字吧。
As far as evangelists are concerned, you all have heard of Billy Graham.
那布永康，我们都啊不是布永康 ，sorry 啊，呀，葛培里，我讲错了，葛培里布道家，你们都听过吧
？Yes， have you heard of Reinhard Bonnke？
布永康
，Okay， yes， you have。What about pastors？
或者牧师们呢
？You've heard of Pastor Saul
啊，主牧师，无名小卒。
You've heard of Rick Warren
这位美国的牧师
，He's the pastor of a 22,000-member church in Saddleback Church in California, I believe.
Yeah, 在马鞍峰这个加利福尼亚州马鞍峰的这个教会，两万多人的教会。
What about Christian writers?
或者是著名的这些作者
，Derek Prince.
Derek Prince 叫做。
Yes.
突然间还忘记他的中文名字。
Watchman Nee, you all know heard of Watchman Nee?
托生。
Yes, yes. Yeah. Yeah. These are some, just a few. But if you look up to them, I have some news for you.
我告诉你，如果你是很敬佩这些人的话
，because they are only a tiny minority.
因为他们是在万人当中的一小群的人。
Compared to the vast majority of lay people like you and I.
但是在万人当中呢，大部分呢都是像我们这般的平信徒啊。
So what makes them godly leaders?
那这些人是怎么样是使他们成为虔诚的领导呢
？Maybe it's their intimacy with God.
可能是他们跟神的亲密的关系。
Maybe it's a strong anointing of God on their lives.
也许是神在他们生命中很强的恩膏。
Maybe God has seen fit to prosper their ministry.
也许神呢愿意呢要使到他们的事工能够兴旺。
And to increase their influence worldwide.
使到他们在全世界都有很大的影响力。
But what about us? We are lay people.
那我们这班代职的人员怎么样呢
？We lay people can also be leaders.
那我们这些代职平信徒也可以成为领袖。
In fact, we are leaders in two areas.
那其实我们可以在两方面做领袖。
We are leaders in the marketplace.
那我们能够在职场当中做领袖。
Wherever we are.
那我们无论在什么的职场。
We could be working in the office.
我们可能是在办公室。
In the commercial sector.
或者是在商界。
In schools, colleges.
在学校学院
，We could also be working at home，
或者是在家里面
，as homemakers，
是在家中当家庭主妇。
Wherever we are in positions of responsibility，
那无论我们是在什么样的一个职场有一个责任
，We are leaders，
那我们就成为领袖了。
We don't have to have anybody come and lay hand and say。You are now a marketplace pastor. We don't have to have that.
那我们现在不需要有人说按手在我们身上说哦，你现在成为在职场上的牧师，不需要这个仪式的。
In fact, we should actually work very quietly and discreetly in the marketplace.
那其实我们在职场呢，我们可以很安静，而且但是却很敏锐的在当中来服侍人。
Sowing the precious seed of the gospel.
那在当中呢，就是把福音的种子撒种。
Perhaps somebody else will.
那也许其他的人做浇灌的事
，and other people will reap the fruit of our labor。
另外有一些人是收割的。
We could also hold leadership positions in church。
那我们另外呢，也可以在教会当中做领袖。
But wherever God places us，
那无论神把我们放在什么地方
，the most important thing is to answer that call。
那最重要的就是回应他的呼召。
You've heard of the five C's in Singapore.
那新加坡的五个 C 你都听过吧
？Car, car, cash, and so on.
Car, cash 这些 C 哈，你们都知道。
Today I'm going to share with you some five C's as well.
那今天我要给你分享另外的五个 C。
The first C is the call.
第一个 C 就是呼召。
It's the call of God upon our lives.
就是神在我们生命中的呼召。
After living so many years on this earth.
那我们在这世上活了那么多年
，Some of you are younger, some of you are older。
我们当中有一些比较年长的，有一些比较年轻的。
All of us must receive that call upon your life。
那我们每一个人都要接受神在我们生命中的呼召。
Have you heard God's call yet？
你听到神的呼召了吗
？If not，
不然的话
you need to speak to your pastor and your leaders.
那你需要跟牧师或者跟领袖来分享。
You need to seek the Lord yourself.
那你需要自己寻求神。
And hear from your elders what is your gifting and what is God's call upon your life.
然后呢，也透过你的教会的长职呢，来明白神在你生命中的呼召是什么。
So what is this call all about?
所以你的呼召到底是什么？
It's all about service.
那你的呼召的重点就是服事。
We are saved not by good works.
那我们不是靠着我们 的行为得救。
In fact, we are saved for good works.
但是呢，我们是为了要做善事而得救的。
All of us are called to serve.
那我每一个人都有一样的呼召，就是要服事的呼召。
Ephesians 2 verse 10 says,
以弗所书第二章第十节那么说，
For we are God's handiwork,
我们原是他的工作，
created in Christ Jesus to do good works,
在基督耶稣里造成的，
which God prepared in advance for us to do,
那就是神所预备叫我们行的。
And for the sake of time, we will not look at the next two verses.
那另外的两个经节呢，我们不会翻阅来看。
But may I ask you to go back and to refer to Matthew 5:16 and Titus 3:8.
那我要请你写下来，然后回去呢，你要找一点时间来看马太福音第五章十六节跟提多书第三章第八节。
There are two types of call, I believe.
那我相信呢，呼召有两种。
One is a very A call for unique, special type of service.
那第一种呢，是一种呼召呢，是叫我们能够在一个很特殊的一个服事里面的。
And because this is an extraordinary service, I believe it requires an extraordinary method of call.
那因为这个服事的这个服事 的款式呢，是一个很特殊的，所以呢，我相信这样的呼召也需要是一个特别的呼召。
Because if God tells you to call, go into some very dangerous part of the world.
那比如说，若神呢呼召你去到一个世界的一个很危险的角落的话，
Where the going is going to be very tough.
那在当中呢，有很多的逼迫，很艰难的事。
He's going to give you a supernatural call.
那他所给你的呼召呢，肯定是一个超然的一个呼召。
He might appear before you,
他也许呢是会出现在你面前
，in a vision,
那在意象中吧
，in a dream,
或者在异梦中
，he can speak into your mind,
他可以在你的意念里面向你说
，and he can even speak audibly to you,
他也许能够让你能够听到他的声音。
But if he's calling you to do something quite ordinary,
但是若他是呼召你做一些比较普通的事
，for example, he's calling you to be an usher in the church,
比如说他呼召你做教会的招待
，he's not going to appear to you in a dream and say,I commission you to be an usher in this church.
他不需要在梦中来出现说，我现在要差传你做教会的招待员。
I mean, he can also do that.
绝对，他如果要这样做也行。
But most likely, he's going to call somebody from the church to approach you.
也许呢，他的方式就是让教会的某一个人士呢，来见你。
This is the call of God on your life.
那这是神要呼召你做的一件事。
You might not be called to be a preacher.
那也许神没呼召你做传道人。
Who knows? One day you might be.
也许有一天你要成为传道人。
But you must start from a very low, humble position first.
但是你的起点呢，一定是一个很卑微、很谦卑的起点。
It doesn't mean that.Ushers are no use in the church.
那并不是说招待都在教会是没用的啊。
Because everybody is important.
因为在教会里面每一个人都很重要的。
But what is your response to somebody who calls you and says, "Brother, sister, would you like to serve in this area or that area?"
若是有人来问你说，弟兄啊，姐妹啊，你可不可以在这方面服事？你的反应是什么？
Don't say no. I can't. I don't want to.
千万不要说，哎呀，不行了，不行了，我不想做啊。
Because it is not him that you are rejecting.
因为你其实不是在拒绝这个人物嘞。
You might be rejecting God himself.
你其实是在拒绝神。
Because God is using the brother sister to invite you to serve.
因为呢，神是借着这个弟兄和姐妹来邀请你去侍奉。
So what is your response going to be?
所以你的回应是怎么样的？
Are you going to reject God?
你是要拒绝神吗？
Please don't be so quick to reject him.
那千万不要那么快就拒绝他哈。
On December the 24th, 1983,
1983年的12月24日,
Brother Sadhu Sundar Selvaraj had a supernatural visitation from God.
那这位弟兄 Brother Sundar 呢，他是神来就是造访他。
God appeared to him and invited him to serve God in the land of Tibet.
那神就是在异象中呢出现，然后呢叫他去到这个新疆去服事。
西藏。
It's a difficult area to serve in.
那在西藏是这个是很困难来侍奉的一个地方。
And brother Sadhu immediately said, "Yes, Lord."
那但是这位弟兄沙杜弟兄呢，立刻就回应，是的，主，我愿意。
And brothers, and God said, "Are you sure?"
那神说，你真的吗
？Don't be so quick to answer.
不要那么快就说是嘞。
Think about it.
你想一想吧。
Another person God called was a Welshman called Rhys Howells.
那另外一个就是威尔斯人叫做 Rhys Howell 的这位弟兄。
God called him to start a Bible college in Wales.
那神呢呼召他在威尔斯开始一个圣经学院。
And who should sign up to be a student would be Reinhard Bonnke.
然后你知道他当中的学生当中其中一位就是布永康。
Not only did Reinhard Bonnke graduate from the Bible college in Wales.
那布永康不单是从这个圣经学院里面毕业。
He was called by God to go to Africa to be a missionary.
那神呼召他去到非洲成为一个宣教士。
And one day in the mountain kingdom of Lesotho, he saw a vision.
然后呢，有一天呢，在 Lesotho 这个山区当中呢，他看到一个异象。
He saw a map of Africa.
他看到非洲的这个地图。
Covered with the blood of Jesus.
那是被耶稣的宝血遮盖着的。
And he felt convicted that God wanted him to evangelize the whole continent of Africa.
那他心中有很强的感动，神要他呢，就是把福音传遍整个非洲大地。
And he answered that call.
他就回应了那个呼召。
And today he's one of the most successful evangelists in Africa.
那今天呢，他是在世界上呢，在非洲最成功的一个布道家。
Winning millions of Africans to the Lord.
那上百万的非洲人呢，就是因着他的布道而进入神的国度。
Recently, I was in the leaders' retreat in Johor Bahru.
那最近呢，我参加了一个在新山的一个领袖的退休会。
And we were divided into small subgroups for discussion.
那我们在讨论的时候呢，分成小组。
And I was seated with a husband and wife.
那我是跟另外一对夫妻坐在一起。
The wife was a cell leader.
那这个妻子是小组组长。
And we were told to discuss about.What strategies we're going to adopt for the coming year?
那所以我们的话题讨论话题是今年的这个事工，我们要用什么策略
？And as the conversation wore on, it was very quickly obvious to me.
那我们谈下去的时候，很快的我就看到观察到了。
That the cell leader was very discouraged.
那这个小组组长他很气馁了。
And the reason was there were some members in the cell group who were lacking in commitment.
那原因呢是呢小组组员呢没有委身小组。
And they even did not turn up for cell group meetings.
他们连小组都不去参加。
So I looked at the husband and the wife.And we tried to think of some solution.
那我就看着这丈夫，然后看着这妻子，然后我们就设法要找出一些答案吧。
So the husband offered his suggestion.
然后呢，丈夫呢就给了一个建议了。
You guess what he said?
你猜一猜他说什么
？He told her to step down from leadership.
他叫她退下啦。
Then I looked at his wife.
然后我就看着这妻子。
She appeared even more discouraged.
她现在更加气馁了。
Of course.
当然更加气馁了。
Husband told her to step down.
因为丈夫叫她退下。
It's a very serious indictment of her ability to lead the group.
那因为这样呢，对她的那个，对她的工作带领的能力是一个很大的一个评级啊。
This is where I decided to step in.
那所以呢，在这个时候呢，我就讲话了。
I told the couple,
我就跟这对夫妻说
that if somebody from church had invited her to be a cell leader,
那我说如果教会某一个人已经邀请她做一个小组组长
most likely three things had to happen before she was invited.
那肯定呢，最很有可能有三件事情已经发生了，然后还有人在邀请她
Firstly, they must have observed her.
第一呢，就是有人在观察他。
Secondly, the church must have interacted with her.
那第二呢，教会肯定呢，不断的在跟他交流沟通了。
And thirdly, the church must have prayed over her before deciding to invite her to be a leader.
然后第三呢，教会肯定呢，已经为着这个人祷告了之后，才邀请他加入做组长。
And because of the fulfillment of all these three conditions.
啊，因为这三个条件都已经完成了。
They had decided that she was fit enough to be a cell group leader.
他们就决定说，这个姐妹呢是配做组长的。
So if they know that she is suitable, she is capable.
啊，因为他们已经知道很适合，而且她有这个能力。
Why should she step down?
那为什么她要卸下呢？
So I suggested something to her.
那另外我做了一些的建议了。
How to deal with those who are not so committed?
要怎么样去帮助那些不委身小组的人
？But I told her, don't blame yourself.
但是我也告诉她说，不要怪自己。
Don't quit.
不要放弃。
It's not your fault.
不是你的错。
So, firstly, the call to leadership.
所以第一点就是。领袖的护照。
Secondly, we want to look at the conditions for leadership.
第二呢，就是条件是什么
？There are several negative conditions.
那有一些有几个负面的条件，我们要讲。
Only one positive condition is required.
但是只要有一个正面的条件就够了。
There are several negative conditions.
有几个负面的。
The person who selected need not be smart.
那被选到的人呢，不一定是很聪明的人。
Need not be eloquent.
他不一定是很有口才的。
Although it may be necessary too, it may be helpful too.
但是有口才的话也不妨了。
It need not be gifted.
也不需要满有恩赐。
Although it may be helpful.
但是有一点恩赐也不错。
Need not to have a good singing voice like our sister Ivy.
啊，不一定要像Ivy 这样有一个很好的歌喉啊。
Although it is also helpful.
但是有的话也不错。
Need not be a Bible school graduate.
也不需要是圣经学院毕业的生。
Although it may help too.
但是有的话也有帮助。
God is not looking for ability.
啊，神所看的不是你的才干。
He is looking for availability.
他所看的是你有没有一颗愿意服侍的心。
Because God is choosing the foolish things of the world.
因为神呢是选择这世界认为是愚昧的。
To shame the wise.
那使到那有智慧的呢羞耻。
God has chosen the weak things of the world to shame the strong.
那神呢选择了这世上的软弱的呢，使到那个以为强壮的他感到羞辱的。
Corinthians, 1 Corinthians
1:26-27.
When Jesus chose his disciples,
当耶稣基督选择他的这个门徒的时候
，Who were they?
他们是谁呢
？The fishermen,
他们是捕鱼的
；The tax collectors,
是税吏
；Even one of them was a traitor.
另外有一个是出卖他的。
All that is required of us,
神所要求我们的是什么？
Is to say like the prophet said.
那就像那个先知的回应。
Here am I.
我在这里。
Send me.
请差遣。
And that's good news for you.
那今天给你一个好消息。
If God is selecting you to be a leader.
如果神在选择你呢，做一个领袖。
Because whoever he chooses.
那他无论选择了哪一个人。
He also equips.
他也装备你。
Hebrews 13:21. Now may the God of peace equip you with everything good for His doing His will.
那愿这个愿那位是平安的主呢，要使到你装备你，使到你能够完成他的旨意。
There's one positive condition I mentioned.
那刚才我提到一个正面的一个条件。
And that's found in 1 Timothy 3:1.
那这里就在提摩太前书第三章第一节。
I've chosen this for my text, but for the sake of time, we'll just look at the first verse.
那这是我的今天的这个经文的主题。那我们只看第一节。
It says, here is a trustworthy saying.
这里说人若想要得监督的职分，就是羡慕上工。
If anyone sets his heart on being an overseer, he desires a noble task.
所以这话是可信的，就是要羡慕上工。
So what is this?Positive condition.
那所以我所讲的正面的条件是什么
？The positive condition is found in this verse.
那就在这经文里面提了出来。
And he says that the overseer must set his heart on being an overseer.
那首先呢，就是他的心就是要定睛在这个职分。
He must want to be an overseer.
他必须要想在，他必须要愿意做一个监督的。
He must accept this invitation to be an overseer.
他必须要接受这样的一个邀请，成为这个监督。
And he must make himself available for the job.
然后呢，他也需要就是愿意把时间释放出来来侍奉。
You know, in the corporate world,
那在这个职场上
，a lot of people are very ambitious。
那有好多人呢，都有很多的这个抱负。
They are very ambitious and they want to climb the corporate ladder to reach the very top。
那他们呢，就是要爬到最高，就是做对公司的领导。
So in the kingdom of God，
但是在神的国度里面
，we want to see more men and women。Prepare to climb and reach the top of what God has in store for them to serve Him.
我们也要希望看到呢，神的仆人的弟兄姐妹们，我们都愿意就是爬到神愿意我们上到最高的层次的服事。
Amen. We certainly do not want to hold ourselves back.
那我们肯定不要就是一直就是不愿意向前。
We want to rise to the top.
我们必须要被提升向上。
And to fulfill God's plans and purposes for our life.
让神的旨意跟神的计划能够完成在我们的生命中。
When you are approached to serve,
那有人来请你来服事的时候
，Don't be very paisei and say I'm not good enough.
那千万不要说paisei说我不够好。
Because before people approach you, they would have done three things.
那因为有人来找你之前呢，他已经做了三件事了。
Observed you, interacted with you, and prayed over you.
他已经观察了你，跟你沟通了，而且呢为你祷告了。
So don't reject the call.
所以千万不要拒绝这样的呼召。
Now the most important thing after you have been selected is.
那你被选上了之后的一个最重要的是
to look after your character.
那就是要照顾你的品格。
In fact, your character has already been studied by your leaders before they selected you.
其实你的品格你的领导已经早已观察了
But it's still very important to guard your character
但是很重要的是呢你要继续的维护着你的品格
The first thing about the character is found in 1 Timothy 3:3
好第一品格的第一个条件呢是在提摩太前书三章三节
It says the overseer must be above reproach
然后这里呢，就是说一个做监督的，你的品格要比别人来得高。
It must be the it means this person must be above reproach, must be blameless.
啊，也就是说呢，你是没有瑕疵的一个品格。
No character flaws.
那你的品格是没有瑕疵的。
And give no grounds for other people to accuse him.
也就是说，不让人有机会呢来谴责你。
Before the U.S. presidential elections,
那在美国最近的这个总统的选举
，all the candidates must disclose their birth certificate, their educational attainments, and the taxation matters.
那所以在任何的选举里面呢，他们需要把他们的个人的资料、履历各方面都要先呈现出来。
Even their private lives are being scrutinized.
那他们的私人的这个隐私的生活呢，也有人在注意的。
You know, recently we read about news from Korea.
最近我们也听到在这个韩国的新闻。
3 years ago,
三年前
the country elected its first female president.
韩国人呢就是选上了他们的第一任的女总统。
Amid much expectation, excitement, and anticipation.
所以呢，国民呢都带着很大的期待，而且是很兴奋这个总统女总统。
3 years later,
三年过了
，end of 2016,
2016年底
，the newspapers reported massive street protests.
然后新闻上我们看到的就是呢，路上有好多人呢都在抗议。
Thousands and thousands of people came to the streets to protest against the president.
千千万万的人都在那边抗议他们的女总统。
They demanded that she resign.
他们要求总统要卸下。
Her approval ratings dropped to only 4%.
那最后呢，就是民意当中就四个百分比的人呢赞同她。
And this year, 2017, we heard that the parliament impeached her.
那所以2017年呢，这个国会呢就是使她弹劾了。
For corruption and abuse of power.
那因此呢就是贪污，还有就是滥用她的权力。
She was certainly not above reproach.
那肯定的，她的品格呢有瑕疵了。
She was stripped of her powers.
她的权力也被拿掉了。
She had to step down as the leader.
她结果卸下，不能够当总统。
A very sad end to her leadership.
真的是对她的领导来讲是一个很悲惨的一个结局。
Secondly,
第二个品格
，the godly leader must be temperate.
那品格一个虔诚的领导呢，必须是性情温和的。
Chapter 3 verse 2.
第三章第二节。
Overseer is to be temperate.
那你的 your 性格需要是温和的。
Temperate means you have to do things in moderation.
那就是说做事呢需要懂得怎么样怎么样和谐和怎么样缓和一点。
You cannot eat too much nor too little.
然后不能够吃太多也不可以吃太少。
You should spend too much money, neither you spend too little money.
不能够太过浪费钱，也不能够太过吝啬。
You spend too much money, you run into debt.
如果乱花的话，就会欠债。
You spend too little money, they say you are stingy.
太过吝啬的话，他说你俭相。
So we must know what are the decent and acceptable limits of our behavior.
所以我们要懂得怎么样，我们的个性呢是要能够有那个中庸的那种温和。
The third point is that godly leaders must be self-controlled.
第三点呢，就是我们需要能够自制、节制。
The Bible has three Greek words.
圣经里面有三个希腊文
that translate into self-control.
这三希腊文有三个字眼呢，是翻译成节制。
The first word is sophrona.
第一个是 sophrona,
found in 1 Timothy chapter 3 verse 2 and Titus 1:8 and 2:5.
是在提摩太前书三章二节跟提多书一章八节跟二章五节。
Now, sophrona has very wide meaning.
Sophrona 是它的意思相当广。
Sensible, trustworthy.
明智能够信赖
It means to have balanced judgment
还有平衡的判断
To be temperate, to be self-disciplined
自律还有温和
To know whether a person exercises good judgment or not
那如果你要知道一个人他的判断好不好
You want to observe how he makes decisions and the quality of his decisions
所以你一定要观察他是怎么做决定而且他做的决定的这个
So, for example, you want to expose them to some imaginary, fictitious situation and see how they make decision.
那也许呢，你说你会给他一个状况呢，然后看他怎么做一个决定。
Or you want to expose them to real life situation and see how they make decision.
那或者是你带他到一个真正的实况当中，然后看他怎么样反应。
So the leadership of the church will observe.Whether their decisions are in line with other people's decisions or not.
那所以领导层呢就能够观察，像这样的人做决定跟这个大体的决定是不是合一的。
And whether their decisions are sensible or not.
还有他的决定是不是好的。
Are they always the odd one out?
或者是不是这个人的决定都是跟别人完全不一样
？When the rest of the group decide on decision A, they decide on decision B.
那每个人说 A， 他就一定做 B。
Are they the odd one out?
他是不是就是跟别人完全不一样
？And secondly, the Greek word for self-control is enkratia.
那第二个希腊文的字眼就是 enkratia.
And this is a much more simple way of defining self-control.
那这个就更加简单一点了。
Found in 2 Peter 1:5-6,
彼得后书一章五节六节
，and Galatians 5:23,
加拉太书五章二十三节。
So 5:23, you know, is part of the fruit of the Spirit.
五章二十三节加拉太书就是讲到这个圣灵的果子。
And enkratia means being self-controlled. That's it.
So enkratia 的意思就是能够控制自己，这样简单的意思。
The third Greek word for self-controlled.
这个 self-control 节制的第三个字眼
is called nepho，
是 nepho，
which means sober。
意思呢就是
being sober，
很清醒。
So it's found in 1 Thessalonians 5:8。
是在帖撒罗尼迦前书五章八节。
It says, but since we belong to the day, let us be self-controlled, putting on faith and love as a breastplate, and the hope of salvation as a helmet.
那但我们既然属于白昼，就应当谨守这个意思，把信和爱当作护心镜遮胸，把得救的盼望当作头盔戴上。
So we can see that self-control has two aspects.
所以你看，这个节制其实有两个层次的。
One is a habit.
那一个呢是一种习惯
，and a habit which is under our control.
那这个习惯是我们可以控制的。
We must purpose in our heart to have self-control.
那我们要心里面决定要做一个节制的人。
And as we are habitually self-controlled.
使到我们能够习惯性的做一个有节制的人。
We develop the fruit of the spirit of self-control.
那我们就可以渐渐的发展这个 圣灵的果子，这个圣啊，就节制的果子。
So that it becomes a part of our nature.
那使到这个就成为我们的我们的品格的一部分。
Why is self-control important?
那为什么节制是很重要的呢
？Because if we lack self-control, we become easy targets for Satan.
那如果我们没有这个节制的话，我们就成为仇敌，我们的仇敌的这个目标了。
He will attack us with all kinds of temptations.
他会用各样的试探来攻击我们。
And if we lack self-control, we will fall under temptation.
那若没有节制的话，我们就容易在试探当中跌倒。
Solomon wrote in Proverbs 25, verse 28.
所罗门王在箴言25:28那么写。
And he says, like a city whose walls are broken through is a person who lacks self-control.
人不制服自己的心，好像毁坏的城邑，没有墙环。
Paul also wrote about self-control in 1 Corinthians 5:7-5.
那保罗呢，也在哥林多前书第七章第五节提到这个节制。
Here he talks about sexual temptation.
那这里保罗提到的是性欲方面的节制。
And he's telling husbands and wives to guard against this.
他告诉做丈夫跟妻子的要懂得怎么样保护自己。
The fourth characteristic and character of a good and godly leader is that he must be respectable.
所以呢，一个虔诚的领袖呢，好的领袖呢的第四个品格就是要可敬。
So what does the Greek have to say about being respectable?
那在希腊文或者希腊人呢是怎么样讲到这个可敬的事呢
？It means that we have to have basic social graces.
那意思呢就是我们需要在社交场合里面要有一个很基本的待人的方式。
We must be well mannered.
那我们需要有礼貌
，courteous.
我们需要有礼貌
and dignified.
而且呢，需要有尊荣。
Good manners.
那有礼貌。
You can't imagine a godly leader to have bad manners.
那你可以没有办法想象一个虔诚的一个领袖呢，但是没有礼貌的。
Where can you observe manners?
那礼貌从哪里看出来呢
？You can have a meal with a leader and you observe how he eats.
你跟他一起吃饭的时候，你看他有没有这样的礼貌了。
Does he put his knife in his mouth?
他是不是吃西餐的时候把刀放在嘴里面
？Are you gonna eat the knife as well?
那你要把刀也吃掉吗
？No, that's bad manners, no.
那个其实是不好的礼貌。
Have you eaten something hard? Do you spit it out?
那或者是咬到你不要咬的东西，然后就吐出来。
Oh dear.
受不了啊，恶心啊。
And after the full meal.
或者吃饱了之后
，you belch very loudly，
然后就，
okay。What about when you are driving？
或者驾车的时候又怎么样
？When people overtake you？
有人就是超越你的时候
，What do you do？ Do you get angry？
你有什么反应？生气吗
？Or do you cut into people's lane as well？
或者呢，你也是那样的，就是很鲁莽的就跑到。别人的车道上
，Or are you a gentleman on the road？
或者你在驾车的时候，你是一个绅士。
Are you as gentlemanly when you're walking on the road and as gentlemanly when you're driving your car？
那你在路上行走的时候，或者驾车的时候，你一样是那种绅士风度吗
？Willing to give way to other people？
让别人先走吧。
Let them overtake you？
那给他们先超越你。
Don't need to get angry about all this？
那不用生气的啦。
You push past people when you're in a hurry.
或者你要赶时间的时候，你越走越快的时候，就把人推开，然后走过去。
I hope it's not none of you are like that.
我希望我们当中没有人是这样的。
Okay, the fifth characteristic of good leader, godly leader.
好，第五个品格是什么呢
？He must have a good reputation with outsiders.
他的名声要好。
1 Timothy 3:7.
提摩太前书。第三章第七节
，The phrase for good reputation in the Greek is translated good witness。
那在这个希腊文的翻译，好名声呢，也翻译成好见证。
He must be a good witness of Jesus wherever he is.
那所以他去到哪个地方，他都要成为耶稣的好见证人。
Not only by his words, but by also his deeds.
不单只是话语的见证，他的行为方面也是见证。
The godly leader ought to be admired by people outside the church.
那虔诚的领袖呢，在教会以外，应该是被羡慕的人。
I have a patient who works in a multinational company.
我有一个我的病人，他是在一个大跨国公司工作。
And in this MNC is also a church elder.
那在这个跨国公司里面，也有一位是做教会领教会长老的。
So one day I decided to be quite kaypo.
那有一天呢，我想我做一点kaypo的事。
I asked the patient.What he thought of this church elder?
那我就问这个病人说，你觉得你那个教会的长老怎么样呢？
Of course, I didn't say to the patient that this is a church elder.
啊，当然我没有跟他讲说他其实是教会的长老。
I just asked him, "Do you know him?"
啊，我就问，你知道这个人物吗？
You know his reaction?
他的反应什么吗？
His face was covered with a smile, a broad smile.
哇，他当时呢就是带着一个很美的笑容啊。
And his eyes lit up.
而且他的眼睛明亮了起来。
When I mentioned his name, his eyes lit up.
我提到这个名字的时候，他的眼睛就亮了起来。
A bright smile.
而且笑得好灿烂。
He said all the wonderful, superlative things about this church elder.
他不断地称赞这个教会长老。
He's a good man.
他是一个好人。
Helpful.
非常的
upright.
愿意帮助人，而且很正直。
Well respected in the company.
公司里面每个人都尊敬他。
So the question I want to ask you is.
那我要问你的问题是。
What do your colleagues say about you?
你的同事是怎么样给你评价的？
When your name is mentioned,
人家提到你的名字的时候
，Are people's faces going to light up?
他们的脸呢是亮起来呢
？Are their eyes going to shine brightly?
他们的眼睛更加的明亮呢
？Or will there be a bowing of head?
或者他们低头了
？Or an uprolling of the eyes?
或者呢，他们的眼睛向上看。
Will people sense that you're different?
有没有他们会不会觉得你是不一样的
？They may not understand why you are so different.
他们也许不明白你为什么跟别人与众不同。
But you know.
但是你知道。
Because you have been with Jesus.
因为你跟耶稣在一起。
And you have the Prince of Peace living in you.
那你有这个平安的君王住在你里面。
And that makes all the difference.
所以这是使到你一切都不一样的原因。
Here is a penetrating question I want to ask you.
现在我要问你一个更加深入的问题了。
Would your unsaved friends be surprised?Or pleased to discover that you are a leader in church.
那你那些还没信主的朋友，他如果知道你是教会的领袖的时候，他是很诧异，还是会很喜悦
？Surprise，
很诧异。
Oh, you are a Christian.
你原来是基督徒啊。
And you are a leader.
哈，还是做领袖的。
And you behave that way.
你这样的行为可以吗
？Or are they very pleased?
或者他们说，哇，实在太喜悦了。
You're a good candidate to be a leader.
因为你根本就是配做领袖的人啊。
So why is this important?
那为什么这是重要的
？Because the unsaved people,
因为那些还没信主的人
are watching us all the time.
他们一直都在看着我们。
Your life may be the only Bible some people ever read.
你的人生可能就是一个人从的唯一的一本圣经他能够看的。
They watch us.
他们看着你。
They examine us and listen to our jokes.
他们查考你，而且听我们的笑话。
They study the way we do our work.
他们观察你怎么做工。
And they note down the way we treat others.
而且呢，他们注意你是怎么对别人的。
And then they draw their own conclusions.
然后他们就下一个结论。
Paul says in 2 Corinthians 3 verse 3.
保罗在哥林多后书三章第三节。
Clearly, you are an epistle of Christ, ministered by us.
那肯定的，你就是主的使徒。
Written not with ink, but by the Spirit of the Living God.
肯定的，你就是主的这个书信，因为不是用字句而写的，而是神的灵在你当中写的。
Not on tablets of stone, but on tablets of flesh.
那不是在石头上面，而是在你的心上。
That is of the heart.
那就是在你的心上。
But notice the warning Paul gives in 1 Timothy 3:7.
然后再注意呢，在提摩太前书三章第七节， 保罗所给的警戒。
And the warning is that so that he will not fall into disgrace and into the devil's trap.
那警戒就是啊，恐怕被人毁谤的落在魔鬼的网罗里。
That's why our lives must guard it very carefully.
所以我们的这一个人生，我们要保护着，保守。
We must guard our reputation very carefully.
要保守着我们的名声。
We must uphold high standards all the time.
我们一定要无时无刻的都维持一个高水准。
And not give an opportunity to the devil to pull us down.
而不让魔鬼呢把我们拉下。
A lot of church leaders have been pulled down by sin.
那很多教的教会的领袖呢，因为罪恶而被拉下。
And when they have fallen into sin, they lose the ability to exercise influence over others.
所以当他们因为罪而跌倒的时候，他们就失去了那个去影响别人的能力了。
They lose their credibility.
因为已经失去了他们的资格了。
And they lose the respect from others.
啊，别人也不再尊敬他们了。
Thirdly, we look at the third C, and that is conflict.
好，第三个 C 呢，就是冲突。
Conflict management is important.
要怎么处理冲突是重要的。
A godly leader must know how to control his emotion.
那一个这虔诚的领袖呢，要懂得怎么样控制他的情绪。
When discussing spiritual matters,
那在讨论一些属灵的事情
，he must not be violent, according to 1 Timothy 3:3.
那他不可以啊、不只是不打人了、他不可以啊、火爆。Okay.
Because when we discuss spiritual matters, these are matters close to our heart.
因为属灵的事情呢，是对我们来讲是很贴心、很重要的事。
And become emotional easily when we discuss such matters.
所以我们讲到这样的事情的时候，我们有时候很容易就会很情绪化。
So avoid being violent.
所以很肯定的，我们不可以暴力。
You would think that this is written for the Israelis and the Jewish people who are known to be quite emotional.
那你以为说这些话呢，是对犹太人，因为犹太人呢是相当的情绪很激昂的。
But no, even in Singapore,
但是新加坡一样是这样。
I've heard of church splitting.
那我听到教会是怎么分裂的。
I've heard of leaders fighting with each other.
我听到
coming to blows with each other.
这个领袖呢，教会领袖是怎么样互相的打斗的。
So some people have a tendency to use physical abuse and verbal abuse.
那有些人呢，就是有这种倾向，用口啦，或者用手啦，就是去惹人的气。
So Paul is saying, don't choose such people as leaders.
保罗说呢，这样的人不可以选他们做领袖。
Don't have somebody who is quarrelsome.
也不要有那些喜欢吵架的。
There are some people who love to fight with other people.
那有一些人就是喜欢打架的。
And argue with people.
喜欢吵架的。
Because they stick onto their position.
因为他们呢守着自己的原则。
And they argue their position to the very death.
然后他们呢就是呢这斗到你死我活了。
And they must win at all costs.
而且一定是我活你死了。
Proverbs 20 verse 3.
然后在这个箴言第二十章第三节
says it is to a man's honor to avoid strife.
然后远离纷争是人的尊荣
But every fool is quick to quarrel.
愚昧人都爱争闹
Thirdly, he must not be quick tempered.
然后另外第三呢，就是不轻易发怒
Titus 1:7.
在提多书一章第七节
，and Proverbs 29:22，
还有在箴言二十九章二十二节
，an angry person stirs up conflict，
好气的人挑起争端
，and a hot-tempered person commits many sins，
暴怒的人多多犯罪。
You know, if you are interacting with people in church，
那你跟教会的人在沟通的时候
，you don't get angry that easily。
可能没有那么容易生气。
But if you're living with somebody at home,
但是如果你是在家中跟一个人一起生活
，that person knows how to get under your skin.
他懂得怎么样哈，什么跟你挑剔嘞。
They know the buttons to push that make you angry.
他知道按哪里扭你肯定生气。
Because these are the same old issues that keep coming up and again and again and again.
因为这样的事呢，已经很多年里面不断的重复了。
And the minute they push the button, you jump.
他立刻一碰到那一个的时候，你就跳不起来。
That's when godly leaders have to be careful.
所以啊，做虔诚的领袖，我们要小心。
Not only in church, but at home as well.
不单只是在教会不生气哦，在家里也不轻易发怒，可以吗？
Fourthly, the godly leader must not be overbearing.
第四方面呢，是不能够任性啊。
Titus 1:7.
提多书一章七节。
An overbearing person is somebody who insists on his point of view.
那一个任性的人呢，就是只懂得坚持自己的观点。
Such that other people must give way to him all the time.
就是说，任何情况呢，对方一定要让步。
Their way is always the best.
因为自己的那一套肯定是最好的。
Their ideas are always the best.
他的意见肯定是最好的。
These people are not team players.
那这样的人呢，是不懂得怎么样团队合作的。
Oh, they will dominate the whole team.
他们会在团队里面一定要带头。
Very easy for the leader.
要做领导好像很容易。
Don't elect this person.
但是这样的人呢，是不可以被选上的。
Don't elect them to any position of leadership.
不让他们做任何的领袖的这个职分。
And finally, the leader must be gentle.
那最后呢，领袖呢，一定要是温和的。
1 Timothy 3:3.
就是在提摩太前书三章三节。
We will not turn into it, but you may also want to turn, refer to Philippians 4:5,
腓立比书四章五节
，Titus 3:2,
提多书三章二三节，James 3:17, 还有雅各书三章十七节。
In the Greek, gentleness has got a wide range of meanings.
那在希腊文呢，这个 gentleness 啊，温和有很广的意思。
It means patience.
也包括耐心
，forbearance，
包括忍耐
，consideration，
包括就是为别人着想
，and personal kindness，
还有个人的恩慈。
A soft answer turns away wrath.
那一个轻声的回答呢，使到生气的人也不生气了。
Yes, a gentle leader is willing to lose even when he is right.
一个温和的领袖呢，即使对也愿意放弃，没关系。
He is willing to yield, willing to forgive.
他愿意就是为别人，而且愿意赦免别人。
He's willing to overlook people's faults.
愿意不看别人的短处。
And my last point, the last C, is C stands for connectivity.
那第四个 C 呢，就是要能够相系。
We've heard about vertical relationships and horizontal relationships.
我们都听过，就是关系呢，有向上的、直的关系，还有横的关系。
I believe we have to connect with God first before we connect with man.
我相信呢，我们首先一定要跟神相系，然后跟人相系。
How do we connect with God?
要怎样跟神相系呢？
We must connect with God through the reading of His Word.
我们要借着读他的话语与神相系。
Not just the reading, but the study, the meditation and the memorization of His Word.
不单是读，而且是要深，是研读，而且是要背，而且还要深思。
Because God's Word gives us a lot of guidance.
因为神的话语要给我们前面所需要的指引。
Psalm 119:105 says, "Your Word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path."
诗篇一百十九篇一零九，你的话是我脚前的灯，我路上的光。
The Word is a lamp to my feet.
那神的话是我脚前的灯。
I can see immediately where I place my feet, where I'm going.
那我的脚要踏的地方，我立刻可以看到。
It's also a light to my path.
而且呢，它是我前面路上的光。
So it is also lighting up the way ahead for me.
所以呢，不单只是前面这一步，前面的这个路上呢，都已经有光亮了。
So God's word gives me immediate guidance.
神的话语给我立刻马上所要走的路，他已经指引我。
As well as long-term guidance,
还有呢，长远的路，他也指引我。
And God's words are life,
还有神的话语呢，就是生命。
They provide life and nourishment to our spirit man,
他给我们的灵里面的人有生命活力。
According to John 6:63,
约翰福音六章六十三节。
Secondly, we need to connect with God through prayer.
那第二方面，我们需要以祷告与神相缔。
I believe leaders need to have a very strong prayer life.
那我相信领袖们需要很强的祷告的生命。
Look at the example of Jesus.
看耶稣的榜样吧。
He had just performed his greatest miracle.
他刚刚成就了一个最大的神迹。
What is the greatest miracle?
最大的神迹是什么？
The feeding of the 5,000.
那就是喂饱5,000人那件事。
Not only 5,000, but if you count women and children, it could easily swell up. The number swell to 15,000 to 20,000.
不单只是五千个男人，如果是把妇女跟孩子的话，可能人数是15,000人。
In fact, 20,000.
或者是20,000人。
With just 5 loaves and 2 fish.
是以五饼二鱼来喂饱这些人。
And after the miracle was over,
那这个神迹发生了之后
，What did he do?
他做了什么事
？Did he give out his name card?
他是不是在那边就发了他的名牌、名卡
？Come and vote for me.
那请你，请你投我一票，投我一票。
No, he didn't.
没有，他没有那么做。
He quickly dismissed the crowd.
他就是叫众人散开
，and quietly slipped somewhere to the mountain top to pray.
然后呢？独自的上山祷告。
And Mark 1:35 says, "In the morning."
那马可福音一章三十五节说，在次日早晨
，way before the sunrise，
是天未亮的时候。
That means he did not have much sleep.
也就是说，他其实睡得很少了。
You climb up to the mountain, a lonely place, and he prayed.
他又到旷野上山，单独的祷告。
May that set a great example for us in our prayer life.
那这个呢，是我们的一个很重要的榜样，就是我们的祷告也要这样。
Secondly, Jesus lived a spirit-led, spirit-filled life.
那另外呢，耶稣他的人生呢，是圣灵充满的人生。
At his baptism,
在他受洗的时候
，Holy Spirit came down as a dove.
圣灵呢，像鸽子一般的降下
，and rested upon him.
然后呢，就是就停在他的肩上。
And then he was led to the wilderness to be tempted by the devil.
然后呢，然后他是被带领到这个旷野去受试探。
And he was 40 days and 40 nights in the wilderness.
在旷野呢，是40天昼夜呢，在旷野里面。
Maybe he did not eat anything.
他什么都没吃吧。
Maybe he had lost a lot of weight and was very tired, very thin.
他已经很瘦了，而且很累了。
Although I'm sure he drank.
也肯定他喝水了。
But under severe onslaught of the enemy.
但是在那个时候呢，仇敌一直都在攻击他。
The anointing of the Holy Spirit was sufficient to give him power and strength and endurance to resist the attack of the enemy.
那圣灵的充满的跟恩膏呢，使到他有那个能力，还有那个毅力呢，来抵挡恶者的一切的试探。
And when he returned triumphant to Galilee after the period of temptation,
所以在这个受试探40天之后，他得胜了回来的时候呢
？Luke 4:14 tells us.
在路加福音第四章第十四节说
，That Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit.
那耶稣是满有圣灵的能力。
So if Jesus required and needed the power of the Spirit so much, what about us?
那若耶稣他需要圣灵的能力的话，那我们又如何呢
？So Jesus had a vertical relationship with God the Father.
所以神呢，耶稣他跟神是有一个这个向上的这个关系。
We would also aspire to have the same kind of vertical relationship.
那我们也要渴慕有这种向上的关系。
Secondly, we should also work towards a horizontal relationship with our fellow man.
然后呢，第二方面呢，我们人跟人之间的关系，我们也要搞得好。
We need to know how to connect with people.
我们需要懂得怎么样与人相系。
The more successful the church becomes,
那教会越成功的时候
，the more busy the pastors become,
那牧师会更加的忙
，the less time they have with people,
那他们跟人在一起的时间就越少了。
When you have a small congregation,
当你的这个会众比较少人的时候
，the pastors probably know all your names,
那牧师知道每一个人的名字。
But when a congregation grows,
但是当教会成长的时候呢
，I think if it's very big, the pastors will just give up trying to remember all your names.
那牧师会放弃想要记人家的名字了。
That's a problem. They stop connecting with the people.
那问题就来了，就是牧师就跟人没有什么接触的时候了。
So godly leaders need to take an interest in people.
那所以呢，一个虔诚的领袖呢，要很关心人。
I recognize not everybody has that gifting.
那我也知道不是每一个人有这样的恩赐。
They need to actually learn how to connect.
他们需要学怎么样跟人相
处。It is an art. It is really an art.
这真的是一个艺术来的。
The story is told of the former president of the U.S. Woodrow Wilson.
那在美国的其中一位前总统呢
Woodrow Wilson.
Wilson.
President Wilson.
President Wilson. Wilson 总统
One day he was in a barber shop.
那有一天他在理发
having his haircut.
他在理发店理发
And he noticed a man coming through the doors of the hairdressing salon.
然后就看到一个男士呢进了这个理发院。
And very quietly, the man slipped into the chair next to him.
然后这个人呢就静静的就坐在他的旁边。
You know, in a barber shop,
在理发院里面
，there's a mirror in front of you.
他前面一个镜子。
And you're interested in who is next to you. You just turn your eyes to one side.Or to the other side, right?
所以如果你要知道谁坐在你旁边的话，你就稍微斜眼看一下就可以了。
Wilson's interest was aroused by the man next to him.
那这个 Wilson 先生呢，他很好奇隔壁这个人是谁。
And he opened his ear to hear what the man had to say.
他就打开他的耳朵听这个人物讲什么。
What did the man say?
他说什么？
It's a stranger.
他是一个陌生人啊。
But every word the man said,
但是这个陌生人讲的每一个字
were the words of kindness, compassion, and interest towards the person, the barber attending to him.
但是他讲的每一句话呢，都是对这个理发师很恩慈的话语，都是很肯定的话语。
Wow, this is a tremendous impact on the former President Wilson.
这番话呢，使到这个 Wilson 前总统 Wilson 他很震撼。
He was very curious.
他很好奇。
And after the man had his hair done,
他头发剪好了
，and went off on his own on leaving the hairdressing salon.
然后离开了。
Wilson purposely stayed behind.
那这个 Wilson 前总统就留下来。
Because he realized that the spiritual atmosphere of the barbershop had changed.
因为他感觉到在这个理发院，他整个属灵的气氛已经改变了。
Spiritual atmosphere had turned electric.
那好像是触电一般的这个气氛。
This was tremendous impact of the words of the stranger on the barber.
因为那个陌生人他所讲的话是很有能力的
，which also impacted all the other barbers in the shop。
那使到呢，在当场的所有的理发师，他们都有受影响了。
And then he was actually reflecting on the identity of the stranger。
那他就在那边想要回想说，到底这个陌生人是谁呢
？And then he realized who he was。
然后他突然间知道了
，it was none other than the famous evangelist D.L. Moody。
哦，他才知道说，原来这个就是那位著名的宣教士，叫做穆迪。
And as he got ready to leave the shop,
所以当这个 Wilson 要离开的时候呢
，he realized something.
然后他另外发现了一件事情。
It was as though he was leaving the church service.
他感觉到好像是刚刚从教会出来这样。
It was as though he was leaving an evangelistic service.
他好像他觉得有点像离开一个布道会。
Maybe also aspire to have that kind of impact on others.
那也许心里面也有想到说，希望也能够这样正面的影响别人。
Speaking words of kindness, compassion.
那把这些恩慈的话，那些带着爱的话带出来。
Concern.
啊，带着关心的话。
Yes. Graciousness.
满有恩典。
May we desire more of God to fill us.
那但愿我们都渴慕神更多的来充满我们。
So that we are overflowing with His love.
使到我们都因着他的爱更多的充满。
So that we can bring His love and spiritual refreshing.
那使到我们也能够把他的爱还有属灵的更新。
To a thirsty and dying world.
带到这个又干渴又快死去的一个世界。
Let's bow our heads for a word of prayer.
我们一起低头祷告。
Father in heaven, we thank you that in your grace and in your mercy, you have called us to serve you.
天上的父，我们要感谢你，因着你的恩典，因着你的怜悯，你呼召我们来侍奉你。
In spite of all our imperfections,
即使我们是那样的不完全
，you have chosen to overlook our faults.
主啊，你顾念我们这些的缺点。
You've called us to serve you.
但是主啊，你却呼召我们来侍奉你。
Lord, we would respond to you this day.
主啊，我们今天要回应你。
And say to you, Lord, we desire to serve you.
也告诉你说，主啊，我们渴慕来侍奉你。
Help us not to be afraid to serve.
帮助我们不惧怕来侍奉。
Help us not to be afraid of commitment.
主啊，帮助我们不惧怕委身。
But help us, Lord, as we serve you, to know that you are also equipping us.
主啊，也帮助我们知道认识你，并且也知道主啊，你在装备着我们。
You're empowering us with your gifts.
主啊，你是又是你，你给我们你的恩赐。
Help us to be more effective.
使到我们能够更有效率。
So we pray that you will empower us.
所以我们祷告你来给我们赐给我们能力。
Equip us.
装备我们。
Fill us.
充满我们。
To better serve you and to extend your kingdom.
使我们能够更好的来侍奉你，并且能够使扩展主你的国度。
So that at the end of our journey, we will hear you say, "Well done, your good and faithful servant."
使到我们在走完这人生道路的时候，我们看听到主你称赞我们说，我们都是忠心良善的仆人。
Hear this our prayer.
听我们这一番的祷告。
For we offer it in the name of Jesus.
我们这一切是奉耶稣基督的名而献上的。
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.